Hi there, I'm Vanita. I love wines and this is The Perfect Pour. Yes, sometimes these wine terms are confusing. While as virtuous ladies and gentlemen, we would never normally talk about someone's body. But in wine, it's not a discussion of shapeliness. Rather, it's an analysis of the weight and texture and the way a wine feels inside your mouth. When people talk about wine being light, medium, heavy, full, you might not know what exactly that means. Today, I'm going to talk to you about body and what it means in the context of wine. Here is a simple tool to remember when you're hearing this or when you're using the term yourself. It's not like sweetness, acidity, or a citrusy flavor that is easy to recognize. Good way to think about the difference between the light, medium, and full body of a wine is the way a skim milk, a whole milk, and cream feels in your mouth. While there are many factors that contribute to a wine's body, the main factor is alcohol. And alcohol is what gives wine its viscosity. It is actually responsible for either that light or heavy mouthfeel we experience when we sip a wine. Here are the general rules. Do not forget to read the alcohol percentage that is always written on your wine label. Wines under 12.5% alcohol are considered to be light-bodied. Some good examples are Riesling, Vino Verde, Italian Prosecco, Pinot Noir, Pinot Grigio, Gamay, Chianti, and so on. Wines between 12.5% and 13.5% alcohol are considered to be medium-bodied. Some examples are Sauvignon Blanc, Chianti Classico Reserva, Barbera, Gruner Veltliner, etc. Finally, any wines over 13.5% alcohol level are considered to be full-bodied. Some examples are Zinfandel, Syrah, Shiraz, Cabernet Sauvignon, Merlot, Malbec, Barolo, Barbaresco, Bordeaux, Chardonnay, and so on. The body of a wine plays a very important role in choosing the wines to pair with food. When you shop for a wine, remember, choose what you like.